Pedro, the Western Point, Sierra Point Fire, not staying here.
I look at it this way. After you've stayed in South City at the airport.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, they're doing us a massive favor. I think it would have been cool. I was very disappointed initially, but now, you know, I'm always trying to do the positive, so I looked to the other side and I went, you know, by comparison, this is awesome. Because we're 15 minutes, I mean, this is a message for Randy family. We're 15 minutes from the airport and a world away.
Fog bless Pacifica, fog that I love. Stand astride her and hide her, day and night from the light up above.
She gone fishing all of the time. Baby gone fishing too. Bet your life, your sweet wife is gonna catch more fish than you. Many fish bites if you got good bait. Here's a little tip that I would like to relate. With my pole and my line, I'm a gone fishing. Yes, I'm gone fishing. And my baby gone fishing too.
Almost an abusive salt marsh. This is the lagoon that is largely, you know, reeds and silted over time. But this is now the 14th hole, this is now the 7th, and we're going to go out here.
Thank you.
Tata.
Bye-bye.
Have helped in some way make this possible in town.
Yeah,
so this is beautiful. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Don, on behalf of Rand McNally and USA Today and Best of the Road, we want to acknowledge you as becoming one of the finalists in the most beautiful category, because that's such an honor. One of the most beautiful, you know, towns in all of America. Like, that just gives me chill bumps. Over 20,000. Yeah. Voted on the site, and over 300 towns were just alone in the beautiful category. So that's really a lot. You had the number one vote. I mean, wow, that's awesome. So we'd like to present you with this.
Best of the Road, Rand McNally, USA Today. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah. All right.
You see here was, you know, volunteers were out here building, they were digging trenches, they were, you know, putting in the water and all that stuff. And actually there's even more information right there too. Actually, so we got it built in 2001, but it started in 99.
I know we've come a long way, we're changing day to day, but tell me, why do the children play?
Spend all day here.
It's really nice, isn't it?
It is.
Okay.
Bark contains aspirin, so they had a source to control temperatures and pain just by making a tea from the bark.
Ooh.
Or chewing the bark, either one. The native people had very little use for their plants, and they knew how to use them. We have one that is in the native plant garden, the outside one that I'd love to show you, called silkwood. And they've had so many uses. You can work up a great lather.
She was one of the first women surfers in all of Northern California, if not the first. Penny'd been surfing her whole life here, and her daughter surfed her whole life, and now her grandkids are surfing, and they're little ones like this, and you'll see down here how unique this place is where we're going to go.
I come in after working, in the Blackbird Cafe. I know every drink, I know every face. I find a little note tucked in my vest. Said, are you ever coming to Shangri-La? And their boat, it was blue. There was a time you could see the crew. They set sail long ago, but in peace they rest. They're gonna make it to no Shangri-La.
there. Okay. Was the boat suited?
On the poets and painters.
Yeah. Both young and old. Tell me what they saw. What truth was told. Being so humble. But to merely suggest. They made it to Shangri-La West. Sun, smile on it, smile on it, smile for the rest. Say it's for real, Shangri-La.
A great time.
Yeah.
I'm happy I got up.
Oh man. So. I couldn't believe it. We were standing there. Like your second wave, you were like, and I'm going, oh, he's and Amy, the head of the thing, she said he must have taken a class before or something. Or surfed before. Can't believe you never have.
I'm happy.
Oh yeah.
Anyway,
give me five, man.
Oh, man.
All right.
Thank you guys.
Yeah.
This has been great.
Did you guys walk?
our station in its later era, you know, when it was clearly just a little place where people were living in it. You know, that's how it looked in the old days.
Sponsoring this contest, a fine old map maker for many, many years. So we decided what would be more appropriate present than to remember Pacifica with the 1892 map by Rand McNally. And I tell you, when we got word from Marianne that Rand McNally was coming, and we are one of six finalists for Most Beautiful, we said, okay, this is an opportunity for us to showcase our town. And Dan and Joanne, I have to tell you, the camaraderie, the teamwork, the dedication, the passion that came out to just showcase our town, even though Mother Nature was hovering very close over these last 2 days, you know what? We just want to give you the warmest welcome and hope you have felt the warmest welcome of sunshine, because we are so happy that we were able to give you the best of what we all know and love about Pacifica. Joanne and Dan, thank you for being here in Pacifica.
We have a goal to have an RV by 2012, so you guys will be seeing our faces back here. And definitely stop in and say hello and make sure you know we're here again. So thank you all.
When we started this trip, we didn't know what to expect, you know. First, it was all about the sun and buildings and plants and, you know. But as we got into this, we really changed, you know. You found that it was just as much the community and the people as everything else. So it's been tough to document that in a way, you know. How do you go back and tell them the feelings that you got from the people that you interacted with? So it's been quite amazing. It's definitely changed our life, you know, meeting this many wonderful people. I think we're going to spend 3 weeks on the road and probably 2 years thanking everybody. So thank you guys very much. It's been wonderful.
Pacifica. There's nothing like it.